Hey everyone, we are at the Ronald Reagan Presidential Library, which is in Simi Valley. It's about 40 miles north of downtown Los Angeles. Now, I've never been here before, but this is something I've always wanted to see. I grew up in the 80s, and I remember Ronald Reagan and the politics surrounding him and everything that he's accomplished, some of the more divisive decisions he made. So I think this is going to be very interesting. I'm looking forward to learning more about his history and seeing a lot of the things that made him, in my opinion, a great president. But even if you weren't a fan of Ronald Reagan, I think this is probably still a great place to go. It is the largest presidential library in America and is often voted as the best of all the presidential libraries by most people. So I'm looking forward to this one. And also, there is a special exhibition. This is the World War II exhibit. So this is running until October of this year, 2022. And we're gonna probably show you a separate short video on that one and what to expect. But that's also something I'm looking forward to, the history around World War II, all the military equipment, and other things that surrounded that horrific war, I think will be something very interesting to see. So come along on this journey with me and let's go and enjoy this museum and presidential library.
For years.
They do have some interesting stuff.
Yeah.
Here's the jacket he wore. There's the bullet hole. Then they have the X-ray where he got shot. And this is his, look at this gun.
Oh wow, look at this table. Looks like you can, this looks like an interactive table here, and you can check out the menus and other things. So here's Margaret Thatcher, dinner with Reagan and what they had. Yum, this looks good. I wouldn't mind eating here. Here's a cool little thing you can do. You can be in the movies with Reagan. Just make sure that you talk loud enough because you can't hear me at all. Oh, it's terrible.
That's cool. Just say no to the board game. Air Force One Pavilion. That's exciting stuff. Well, it's pretty crazy how they fit that in here. The wingtip comes all the way right here. Look at this. You can almost reach it. Technically, I could reach it if I wanted to, but I don't think that's appropriate. So these flags here represent all the countries that Ronald Reagan traveled to while he was in office. So there are 26. And then here's some of the highlights. Look at the uniforms. Much different. This is in Korea and the DMZ. Presidents don't really do this stuff anymore. It's a shame. So here's all the places he's been in each year, and then how many flight miles he traveled during that year. So here's the evolution of the Secret Service from 1865. Okay, so here's the irony of this. So he established the Secret Service on April 14th, 1865. That was his last official act as president, and that evening he was assassinated. Wow. So this room shows how they actually brought the plane into this museum, which is pretty insane. They basically took it apart. Look at this command center. It's not even that big. It's like straight out of the movies. Look at all these buttons. Like a, there's the galley. There's your oven. I guess they probably had pretty decently fresh food compared to airlines. Here's his office, and he's always got his jelly beans. Lots of phones. I guess he slept back there. This is a C-137C. Yeah.
That's military, 707.
707, that's what he was saying, yeah. Okay, wow.
You guys are aware that seven presidents sat in here.
Seven?
Uh-huh. The first one was Richard Nixon, 1973. The first one on here was George W. The last one, George W., 2001.
Seven presidents used this plane
before.
That's crazy.
Really?
I guess this is where Nancy sat. Did Nancy smoke? Looks like an ashtray. She says don't do drugs, but she smoked. I'm not sure about that. Says not authorized for viewing classified tapes. Here's the meeting room. More jelly beans in the corner. Jelly beans and fruit.
This when the plane was in service, this was not open like this. They had a wall here.
Working hard or hardly working? You've been sitting here for hours and you haven't written a damn thing. Come on, buddy. Let's go, Chilander. Get to work, buddy. I have to talk to the president. Slacking off on the job. Don't know if this is a staff and guest compartment. Not a lot of seating in here. That's a cute picture. Another eight people. Now, is this one the press? When do we get to eat the chocolate cake?
Yeah, I wish. Always a fresh cake on board. Usually it was one of these chocolate ones, which was his favorite.
Here's the motorcade. And the history. In 1907 was the official first motorcade for Teddy Roosevelt. Check out this cop car. LAPD Impala from the 80s. It reminds me of all the old movies. It's a pretty big helicopter here. If people are wondering why the flag is faced backwards on this side, it's because if you're moving forward, the flag flows backwards. So the other one will also be pointing in that direction, but will look the right way around. So in case people didn't know that one. So here's the big disappointment of the day. The Ronald Reagan bar, sandwiches, everything closed and not opening. It's not like we're here too early. It is closed until further notice, I guess, because of the pandemic. Very, very disappointing. I always like grabbing a beer after walking for a couple hours. So this is Simi Valley. It's sunny out with a nice cool breeze. So you're not gonna sweat, but it's absolutely gorgeous. Pretty much some of the best weather I've ever had in my life. Another thing to know when you come here, they have picnic tables outside. So if you want to bring food and have a picnic, you can do that. There is a bistro inside, a little expensive, but if you don't want to do that, then I suggest that you bring some food with the family and enjoy the great California weather. My brother got arrested at Checkpoint Charlie when he was a kid because he had museum papers in his pocket that showed the wall. And he was apprehended for 4 hours. He was 17 years old in 1988.
This wall.
So we just finished, we spent a few hours here. This was a really great museum, I really enjoyed it. If you wanna learn more about the history of Reagan, his policies, as well as his life, you know, growing up, before he became governor, when he was an actor, when he was a governor of California, then president, and then his life after his presidency up until his death, it's all covered here, which was very interesting to see and to read about. and I learned a lot of new things about him. It was a great experience. You could spend, I would say, at least 2 hours just on the Ronald Reagan piece of the library, that museum. And then there's also Air Force One, which was a lot of fun to check that out. It was very interesting. And the people working here are very knowledgeable. So if you have any questions, I would go and talk to them. They know a lot about the history and they're incredibly friendly. So that was a great part of the museum as well. Now, I didn't mention before, but we're here on a Tuesday. And I read that Tuesday is the slowest day. So we got here when it opened, which was 10 a.m., and found that the crowd was very good sized. You never felt like you were in the way of anybody or anybody else was in the way. So I think that if you come to Los Angeles and you have the opportunity to come to this museum, then I would suggest trying to get here on a weekday, because this is a very popular place. On the weekends, it is incredibly busy. Now, just a fair warning, if you go onto the website, it's $16 for the library general admission. However, when they have a special exhibit, they actually increase the price. So if you come here and they have the World War II exhibit, that will be $29.95 for adults per person. I thought it was well worth it. Definitely check it out. I really enjoyed myself, and we will see you guys on the next one. Have a great day.